So next point is composite supply and mixed supply. Composite supply and mixed supply is the extension to supply, definition of supply. Section 8A talks about composite supply and section 8B talks about mixed supply. Okay. Now this concept was there under old laws as well, in service tax, in excise, this concept was there. But GST have given it its appropriate words and its meaning. Alright. For tax evasion purpose, lot of assessees, they try to classify product under different categories. Like, say for example, pencil is having rate 18% and eraser is having rate 28%. I'm just taking example, I'm not speaking about real rates. Okay. What is the rate of pencil? I said 18%. And what is the rate of eraser? 28%. Yes or no? 18% and 28%. Now my problem is this, there are pencils available separately and there are erasers available separately. If you manufacture pencil, you will pay 18%, and if you manufacture eraser, you will pay 28%. My issue is that you are manufacturing pencil and on top of that you are putting eraser. Have you seen that type of pencil?
Yes.
So question, yeah, that type of, can you give me so I can show it? Okay. So this is pencil and this is eraser. And because the rates are different, now I have to classify it either under 18% category or under 28% category. Now you tell me, you use your brain and tell me, what is the right category for this? 18 or 28? Some people are saying whichever is higher. Higher means I have to pay 18%, 28%. What is it for you? If I ask you to call one word, I know this is pencil plus eraser. But if I have to ask him, okay, give me your eraser, so will he give me this?
No.
But if I ask him, please give me your pencil, then he will give this?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
So he understand this as a
pencil.
A shopkeeper also understand this as a
pencil.
So according to trade parlance, naturally we look at this as a pencil. So the principal component, the main component of this product is what? What is the main component in this product?
Pencil.
Therefore, it should be classified as a pencil because this is a naturally bundle. This is
naturally,
although there are two products, but this is naturally bundle. So and main product here is pencil. Therefore, it should be classified as a pencil. Am I clear? Well, this is one example. Second example, when you purchase mobile, you get mobile, then charger. Yes or no? And hands-free also. Some phones are not providing hands-free now, but in some packets it was there. Yes or no? Can you buy hands-free separately? So headset is separately available in the market?
Yes.
Charger separately available in the market? Mobile cover is separately available in the market? Scratch guard is also separately available in the market?
Yes.
But when you purchase new mobile, sometimes all these products are kept in one box and they are giving you.
Yes.
So you understand, classification is the problem. If rates are different, for charger rate is different, for a scratch guard rate is different, a camera cover rate is different. So how will I look at this particular product? When you get that box in hand, what will you say? I purchase mobile camera, charger, hands-free, cover.
No.
Or you will just say, I purchase new mobile.
New mobile.
So for you, this is not a box. Although it is a box of commodity, mix of commodity, but for you, the main product is?
Mobile.
Main product is mobile, and therefore it should be classified, whole product should be classified as mobile, and rate of mobile is applicable on all product. Are you getting this?
Yes.
Although individually their rates are different. Okay.
Yes.
Am I clear with this? What is the business of Air India? Passenger transportation. But I told you Air India also provide food service.
Yes.
So Air India is not hotel, no? Because on hotel, this hotel services, if you go here, what is the GST rate that you pay?
85.
Hotel Baba food 5%, 2.5 you pay, don't say 18. Alright. And air transport passenger it is 18%. Please understand. Now Air India is confused because if you all are my passenger, I'm giving you two services in one ticket. If I charge separate,
yes.
If I charge separate, passenger ka 10,000 rupees, passenger transportation 10,000 rupees, food 500 rupees. So on 10,000 I will put 18%, on 500 I will put 5%. Are you getting this? But my problem is that I don't charge separately. I charge inclusive. Okay, 9,000 inclusive. Everything is there in 9,000. Hello?
Yes.
Now on 9,000, which rate I should put? 5%? or 18%?
18%.
Why 18%? Because what is the main purpose of service? Yeah. Passenger transport by air, yes or no? It's not that you are hungry, so you are thinking about which hotels to go, Shiv Sagar or that Boston or, you know, Persia Darbar or Taj or Air India. People don't go to Air India for having food, no? People go to Air India for? So what is the dominant service? Out of both are service, both are important, but one is dominant in nature. Air transport, yes or no? Similarly, one more example I would like to give you is a hostel, hostel facility, boarding school. In boarding school, what happens? Boarding schools gives you three facilities, minimum three. Some boarding schools are giving more than that, but minimum three facilities will be available in boarding school. Come on, tell me. Accommodation will be there. Food will be there. See, you people are not saying education first. You understand your priority? When I am saying boarding, the first word should be education. Along with education, accommodation. And because you are staying and studying there, they should provide you food. People are like, accommodation, food, sometime education. So important component is food and accommodation. But whatever it is, you tell me, what is the main service out of these three? Because problem, I will tell you, the problem is this, education is exempt in GST. Education is not taxable. Food is taxable at 5% and accommodation is taxable at 18%. So out of three services, one is exempt, one taxable at 5 and one taxable at 18. And that boarding school is charging you 30,000 for all. So my question, boarding school is asking you a question, should I completely exempt it? Should I completely tax at 5%? Or should I tax it at 18%? What should I do? It is a bundle. It's a bundle. You understand? Bundle of service. So what is the dominant service out of this?
Education.
And because education is exempt, whole activity will become exempt. This is composite supply. This is composite supply section 8A. That composite supply says, look at what is the dominant in nature. Principal supply. Look at the, you understand, principal supply means main supply, dominant, powerful supply, and then all other activity will take color from that particular principal supply. If principal is exempt, all other activities will be exempt. If principal is taxing at 5%, all other activities will become taxable at 5%. If principal is taxing at 18%, then all activities will become taxable at 18%. Are you getting this? The exact opposite of this is mixed supply. Okay. These are naturally bundles, naturally this happen, nobody is planning to evade taxes in this, okay? Now mixed supply is exact opposite to composite supply, okay? Have you heard that song, Niche Phoolo Ki Dukan Upar Gori Ka Makan? So this is Gori and this is Dukan, alright? Dukan means this is commercial room, commercial premises, and this is the residential premises, okay? Commercial premises and? Residential premises. As per GST exemption, residential premises for residential purpose is exempt. Commercial premises for commercial activity is taxable. Alright. So you are having G plus one room. You understood this?
Yes.
Ground floor is taxable, but first floor is exempt. Yes or no? Now you will apply your brain and what will you think? You will think to evade taxes because people are there to evade taxes. People are evading taxes. Alright. So what will you do if you charge 20,000 rent here and you know 40,000 rent here? This 40,000 is taxable and 20,000 is exempt. But you will not do this. You are smart, no? You will charge 55,000 lump sum. Yes or no? You will say I will give both house to only one tenant, not to separate tenant. 55,000 lump sum I want. Yes or no? And you will try to show this whole 55,000 is for residential, not taxable. Okay? Then government will catch you one day. Hello? And then government will say, sir, this is not naturally bundled. This is not naturally bundled. This you are doing with the intention to evade. What is the intention behind doing this? Evade taxes. This is not natural bundle. This is artificial bundle created with the objective of evading taxes. We will punish you by putting this whole 55,000 as a commercial property. So you had choice to separate it. If you separated it, then we don't have any problem. You showed a whole 55,000 as a residential, we will show whole 55,000 as a commercial and we will take tax on whole amount. Hello?
Mm-hmm.
This is one example. Have you heard that with a cold drink, refrigerator free?
No.
You buy cold drink from us, refrigerator free. Yes, this is offer. Coca-Cola, PepsiCo give this offer. You buy cold drink from us, refrigerator free. Not to you guys, for this shopkeepers. Have you seen that transparent refrigerator? Not our gharwala refrigerator. In shop, Coca-Cola is written there, big Coca-Cola. That means it is given by Coca-Cola to that guy. And what is the contract with that guy, you know? You will sell only Coca-Cola product. Therefore, we are giving you refrigerator free. So you are not buying refrigerator from us. You buy only cold drink. But this many carrots. Some minimum carrots will be there. Like 1,000 bottle you bought from us. And then we will give you refrigerator free. Now you tell me, is it a naturally available in market?
No.
No, it is artificial. So what rate should I put on that? So they say, look at the rate of cold drink. Look at the rate of refrigerator. And charge highest possible rate. What you should charge? In 8A what we have done? In 8A we have followed principal supply. And 8B exactly opposite. We will check under which situation SSC will be liable to pay highest amount of tax. Mujhe de deta. It's okay. 8A, 8B. Alright, so 8A is a composite supply, 8B is a mixed supply. Alright, 8A is a composite supply, 8B is a mixed supply. What is the law of 8A? 8A say, look at the principal supply and charge tax as if whole supply is a principal supply. Whereas 8B is a mixed supply, not naturally bundled. Tax evasion usually is done there. So government say, look at the intention of SSE, and if intention is wrong, then teach SSE lesson by putting highest possible tax liability. Okay, so law is different for composite supply and mixed supply. What is the tax rate? We have to select tax rate. Finally, we have to select tax rate. If it is a naturally bundled, then which tax rate you will take? Tax rate of principal supply. If it is a mixed supply, which tax rate you will select? Highest rate. So in Diwali also they make this packet, no? Cheese, chocolate, dry fruits, some mix they do. Okay, it's not normally available. So you are packing this all different commodity and giving this back to customers. Yes or no? This is not normal bundle. This is not normal bundle. So we will try to put highest tax rate. There are packets in mall. Sometimes they give wallet, belt, watch, and tie. And every item have different rate. Yes or no?
Yes.
Which rate they will take on bundle? So whole rate. You know, there is a shaving kit. Brush is separately available. Razor is separately available. Aftershave solution is separately available. Yes or no? But I am creating one shaving kit, one box, and I am putting all these things there. And I am selling you box. Which rate you will select? Highest possible rate. Are you getting this?
Yes,
why? Because this is, now which item is composite supply and which item is mix supply. I cannot give you list. Please understand. I cannot give you list. That is the situational. Hello? There is no blanket rule. You cannot buy it. Okay. This is the, like one example I gave last time in lecture, and one student have commented. Maybe from Kerala he has commented. I gave you example. In last batch I gave one example. I said sometime this Colgate or these companies who are selling toothpaste, they sell toothpaste and they put brush into it. Yes or no? So I said, if rate of brush is different and rate of toothpaste is different, which rate we will select? Is it composite supply or is it mixed supply? So I said it is mixed supply. Who gave you confidence to say it is a mixed supply? Why not it is a composite supply? Because in ICI institution, our institution, there is one question in which it is written as a mixed supply. Hello? In one question, answer is written as a mixed supply, not composite supply, it is a mixed supply. Why? Can I sell brush independently?
Yes.
Yes. Can I supply toothpaste independently?
Yes.
If both can supply independently, then you should supply independently. Why are you putting in one box and selling it?
Yes.
Then that student commented on it. Sir, but what is the use of toothpaste without brush? So he doesn't know. He has never used, I guess he has never used toothpaste without brush. Did you use toothpaste without brush?
Yes.
Whenever we go to relative's house and you forgot the brush, what will you do? So, can toothpaste be used? without toothbrush.
Yes.
Yes, therefore toothpaste and brush is independent supply. Toothpaste and brush is a, but still they are putting in together in one box and they are selling it. Are you getting? Don't look at him. No, look here. Full day lecture is going on. You are like mad people. You ignore them. Let him enjoy his life. Yeah. So let's quickly look at the distinguish between these two. Okay. Composite supply and mixed supply. 8A, 8B. How to read it? 8 clause A, section 8 clause B. Okay. Here also it consists two or more supplies. When will you call composite? It's a bundle. It consists two or more items. Okay. For a single price. For a single price. Here also it is two or more items for a single price. So the basic definition is same. Okay. Next. This is naturally bundled. This is not naturally bundled. This is artificial. Here intention is tax evasion. Majorly it is tax evasion. Okay. Next. This is in conjunction with each other. In conjunction with each other means if I have to sell you pen, I have to put refill into it. Yes or no?
Yes.
Although refill can be sold separately, but in first case, I have to put refill inside the pen, otherwise nobody will buy the pen.
Yes.
So it is in conjunction with each other. Yes or no? When you purchase new bike, some 1 liter petrol they already put into it.
Yes.
Because on first day itself, they don't want to experience you. Okay, from showroom, you push it to the petrol pump. That is not a right thing, no. Some petrol they have to put into it, okay? So it is a conjunction to each other. Okay, yeah? Here it is, it can be supplied, like toothpaste and toothpaste. It can be supplied separately, but still they are supplying as a?
Together
bundle. So it is option here, no, it is a choice here. Tax liability, here we will take rate of principal supply, here we will take rate of highest possible tax rate. Now what is principal supply? So I said which is the dominant element, okay, predominant, which is powerful in that. Some examples we have taken, goods with packing material, yes or no? So when you buy beer, they don't give you in hand, no? They give in glass bottle. And like glass bottle have separate rate and beer is having separate rate, or beer is taxable under state excise, glass is taxable in GST. So what is more important, glass bottle or beer?
Beer
is more important. So that there are two products, no, glass bottle and beer. But whole product we have to call it as a beer, because what is predominant? Beer. Yes or no? Camera with camera cover. You know, camera covers are very costly. If camera is of 1 lakh, then cover must be at least 5 to 10,000 rupees cover. But when you buy camera, they give camera plus camera cover. Now we cannot tax them separately. Why? This is composite supply, yes or no?
Yes.
Alright, this is naturally they give camera and camera cover, okay? TV electronic with warranty. Warranty is a service and TV is a goods.
Yes.
They are giving it together.
Composite,
because normally they give a warranty.
Yes,
yes or no?
Yes.
Alright, traveling with free food, this airline, okay? Mobile with charger, okay, composite. Weak supply, packaged food articles, chocolate, chips, biscuits, etc. Cold drink with refrigerator.
Yes.
Okay. Residential house with commercial house. Okay. Toothpaste with toothbrush. Alright. Pack of watch, tie and belt. So these are the examples from my side. Now your institute example. Okay. This is the theory written by your institute. Let us talk with example directly with questions. Booking of air ticket which involves cost of meal be provided during the travel. Come on, tell me. Composite supply or mixed supply? Composite supply or mixed supply? Air India example.
Composite
supply. Rate will be charged by principal product. What is the principal product? Air transportation. Okay. Next. Message P Limited enter into a contract with Z Limited for supply of goods where goods are packed and transported with insurance. Goods are packed and transported with insurance. The supply of goods, packing material and transport and insurance is the composite supply. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. So they are giving 2-3 items. Are you getting this?
Yes.
They are giving you goods, they are giving packing material and they are giving insurance. It is naturally bundled. They are saying it is naturally bundled. Therefore, I am also saying it naturally bundled, because there is no hard and fast rule for dividing what is mixed supply and what is composite supply. It is completely situational, and in case of dispute, court will give final judgment whether it was a composite or whether it was mixed supply. Till the time court judgments are not there, our institutes are given giving us examples. We will follow same example. If institute saying it is a composite, we will assume it is a composite. Okay, which is logical also. It's not illogical. Okay. Five-star hotel provide 4 days and 3 night package with breakfast. You know, in five-star hotel, breakfast is complimentary. Five-star hotel rent is 18% and breakfast rate is 5%. So what rate they will charge? Do you wanted a breakfast, therefore you stayed in hotel?
No.
Or you stayed in hotel and then you got complimentary breakfast? What is main activity?
Stay
in hotel, therefore the stay rate should be charged on whole bill. Okay, so composite supply, principal supply is stay in hotel accommodation. Hotel accommodation. All right, next, can I go ahead?
Yes.
Just few days back I told, you know, Anjesh sir got married and then Anjesh sir book one hall. All right, hall also, like here for marriage hall also was booked. Now that hall had a contract, they will give us chair, table, you know, whole decoration and food also. They say we will charge only for food, 1,000 rupees per plate or something like this. Yes or no? All right, so what should be the GST rate on it? 5%. What is the main purpose? Food is the main purpose or hall is the main purpose?
Hall.
Convention hall is the main purpose. Therefore, although they are charging for food, still they will charge 18% GST. On invoice, they must charge 8, not 5%. 18% GST. Convention hall bill. Am I clear? Because hall is important. With hall, they are providing us chair and food. So principal supply is hall. Marriage hall. Am I clear? Yeah, just practical issue. Next, Ravi being a dealer in laptop, sold laptop bag along with the laptop to customer. This also happens normally in market. Laptop and laptop bags are sold for 55,000. CGST, GST on laptop is 18% and laptop bag is 28%. Are you getting confusion?
Laptop
is 18. So you wanted a bag, therefore you bought a laptop.
No.
Or you wanted a laptop and then you got a bag along with it.
No.
So principal supply. 18%. So my rate is 18% on whole 55,000. 18%. Understood the game?
Yes.
Because it was covered by section 8A, composite supply. Okay, principal supply. Next, Diwali gift hamper which consists different items like sweet, chocolate, cakes. Come on, tell me.
Mixed
supply. What will you take?
Highest
rate on whole packet.
Yes.
Okay. If there is a 5%, 5%, 12%, 18%, and 28% item. Whole packet will have get 28% rate. Am I clear?
Yes.
Next. X Limited, a dealer, offer combo packs of shirt, watch and wallet and
mix
supply. Highest rate. Okay. Mr. A book a Rajdhani train ticket which includes meal and it mix. Is it composite or mix? Rajdhani. Rajdhani, no, it doesn't stop anywhere. It is composite. Huh? Composite supply. Space Bazaar offers free book bucket with detergent purchase. You know this?
Yes.
If you purchase this Tide, Surf Excel, you will get one bucket free. Is it a composite supply or mixed supply? Assume rate of GST on detergent is 28% and bucket is 18%. You wanted a bucket?
Detergent.
Or detergent?
Detergent.
But can it be bought separately? Is it necessary that every time you buy detergent you will buy bucket?
No,
it's not like that. So it is not composite. This is what they are saying.
Yes.
All right, they are saying it is not composite. I'm also saying it is not composite. It is mixed supply, and there, because it is a mixed supply, highest possible rate should be charged. I told you there is no hard and fast rule. There is no blanket rule. You have to read examples and remember examples. Okay. So one more example you can put in your mixed supply. No.
Yes.
You have written mixed supply examples in your. Notebook. Okay, one more example you can put for mixed supply. What example we got?
Detergent
with bucket. Detergent with bucket. It is a mixed supply, so highest rate we will take. Okay, sure. So this is the end of section 8A and 8B.